Hello, today I have a client with a short beaten nails and I'm going to transform it into beautiful coffin shape. If you are interested, keep watching. First, I did dry manicure, which I have to admit was not an easy one on these nails. So then I gently push back the cuticle and remove the surface shine. I'm using 180 grit. On top of short beaten nails, this client also have hyperhidrosis and over excessive sweat on her fingers and skin, which makes it so hard to do the application. Now remove the dust and apply one coat of dehydrator. With these nails you can apply two coats, and then non-acid primer for acrylic, and start the application. First, I will take acrylic bead and place it right on the free edge and start creating the new free edge, because there's no way we can fit the form. Well, we could, but it will be a struggle, and also it will be extremely hard to put the form under the nail. So I think there is the better solution. Wait for a couple minutes until it's polymerized, and then we can carefully take metallic spatula or orangewood stick and separate the product from the skin. So now we basically created the new nail with a new free edge, and now we can easily fit the form under it. So I'm placing the form. I prefer to work currently with the plastic forms, and then start working like usual. Just pretend that this was the original nail with its free edge, and sculpt the ballerina shape like you usually do. So first I take acrylic pearl and create free edge. When I'm working with this kind of nails that are not very easy to work with, I usually use several beads because it helps me to create a better structure of the nail. And also, honestly, I hate filing, so I always try to do my best with the brush and with the sculpting to avoid this filing part as much as possible. Then I place another bead, as we definitely need more product there in the center to create apex, and stretch it towards the free edge. I'm working with brush number 8 because these nails, I don't know if you can see it through the screen, but they are tiny, they are very small, so brush number 10 or 12 would be definitely just too big for these nails. Also, I need to add another bead on the free edge as we need more product there. And I try to make the surface as smooth as possible, as well as the line of the free edge. And now I'm getting closer to the cuticle. Stretch another bead right there. Do not take too much monomer, especially when you're working with a client with the lateral walls, because if you will, it's possible that you will flood the cuticle, or the product will go too close to the cuticle or to the sidewalls, and it will be almost impossible to file off the product from there. So I recommend to work with the proper consistency at all times, and it will really help you to achieve better results. So now I check if there's enough. A small additional bead right there, and now we can easily remove the form, carefully separate it and put it from the nail, and then I'm pinching it with a pinching tool and apply the plastic clamp for a couple minutes. Now it's time for filing. So I only need to file the surface a little bit, the cuticle area, and that's pretty much it. Like I said, I honestly hate filing, so I try to do everything so I will not have to file much. With a ballerina shape, you need to file sidewalls carefully, make sure that they have the same angle, so always check from the side view, from the top view. Then we will buff it, remove the dust, and the last step will be sealing with a top coat, in case you want to leave these nails nude. So I apply it and cure in LED lamp for 30 seconds. And this is how the nails looked at the beginning, short and beaten. And this is what we created at the end, beautiful ballerina shape. I think that ballerina or coffin shape is one of the best solutions for wide and short beaten nails, as it makes hands and nails look really elegant and feminine. Let me guys know what do you think, and what kind of shape do you usually choose for your clients with the short beaten nails. Thank you so much for watching. If this is your first time on my channel, consider subscribing, as new tutorials and videos just like this one are coming up every week. See you in my next one. Bye-bye.